वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे अ वेरी वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक अगेन फ्रॉम द फर्स्ट सेमेस्टर ऑफ फूड प्रोडक्शन, स्टॉक्स विच आर बेसिकली नोन एज फॉन्स दे क्विजीन इन फ्रेंच लैंग्वेज. व्हाट डज इट मीन एक्चुअली? इट मीन्स फाउंडेशन ऑफ द किचन. एंड व्हाई इट इज़ नोन एज फाउंडेशन ऑफ किचन? बिकॉज इंस्टेड ऑफ वाटर वी यूज स्टॉक while making soups, sauces and gravies in a professional kitchen. And why it is used in place of water? Because definitely it has more nutrition, more flavor, more aroma as compared to water. So I am going to take you through this important topic in detail. And I will tell you what are the different types of stocks, what are their uses, how to use a stock, what care should be taken while you are making a good stock, and how you can actually do wonders with your dishes if your stock is well prepared. So we start. Stocks are called as foundation of the kitchen because they form the base for many soups, sauces and gravies. As I told you, a stock is a flavorful and nutritious liquid which is made by gently simmering the bones and vegetables, or vegetables. In case you are preparing just a vegetarian stock, then no need to add bones. And in case you are preparing a non-vegetarian stock, then you need to add the animal bones also. They are basically simmered in a water to extract the flavor, aroma, color, body and nutrients. So basically telling you simply how you can prepare a stock is you can prepare it with leftover vegetable peels, for example carrot peels, pea peels, green vegetable peels which are left in your kitchen. But never use any starchy vegetable because that will spoil your stock, that will create cloudiness in your stock. So always use green vegetables. The classic recipe for preparation of stock is that simply you take these four things. The four essential parts of a stock are marpua, which is basically roughly cut root vegetables like onion, carrot, celery and leeks. Okay, we call it OCCL, onion, carrot, celery and leeks, which are roughly cut. They are known as marpua. Then bouquet garni, which is a bunch of herbs tied together in a muslin cloth. It includes bay leaf, parsley, thyme and peppercorn. Then water and animal bones. That's it. You require these four things to prepare a good stock. But the proportion of these should be in balance. It should be according to the recipe of the stock which you are preparing. Now there are several variations of stock. For example, non-vegetarian stock you can prepare with chicken bones, and it could be white, it could be brown. Non-vegetarian stock could be white or brown in color. Basically it turns brown if the bones which you have added into the stock, you have browned the bones, you have roasted the bones before putting them in water. So they will definitely give a brown color to the water and your stock will be brown in color. Then you can use fish stock, fish bones for preparing fish stock. And fumé is another name for flavorful fish stock, especially in which wine is added. Okay, we also call it côte bouillon, C-O-U-R-T-B-O-U-I-L-L-O-N. Côte bouillon or fumé is a fish stock. And basically côte bouillon is used for poaching the fish, and fish is poached in a special vessel which is known as fish kettle. There could be red wine côte bouillon or white wine côte bouillon. Marpua, as I told you, it's roughly cut onion, carrot, celery and leeks. Bouquet garni, a bunch of herbs, bay leaf, thyme, parsley and peppercorn. So this is the ideal proportion of these ingredients. Bones should form 50%, marpua should form 10% and water 100% of the recipe. I mean, if you are taking 1 liter of water, then you have to take 100 grams of marpua and you have to take 500 grams of bones. So these are the different types of stock: white stock, brown stock, fume is a fish stock, coat puyo is again a fish stock, glaze is a reduced stock. So while you are preparing a stock, you cook it for a desired amount of time depending on the bone which you are using. If you are using a bone from a big animal, you need to cook the stock for a long period of time. As compared to a small animal bone like fish bone or chicken bone, the stock gets prepared within 20 to 25 minutes. But in case you are using lamb bones or beef bones, beef bones are being used, it requires at least 12 to 16 hours of simmering. Then only the bones will release their flavor and gelatin. So what is gelatin? Gelatin is basically a protein which is present in animal bones, and it is released into the stock while you are simmering it in water, while you are simmering the bones in water. So while you are simmering it, it gets released into the water, and when you keep on simmering this for a long period of time, what happens is water starts evaporating and there is a concentration of gelatin in liquid, and that leads to formation of a glaze, which is a reduced or thickened stock, right? Remoulage. What is remoulage? Remoulage is basically reuse. It's a French word for reuse. So some people, what they do is, once they have prepared the stock and they have strained the stock, they have removed the marpua, they have removed the bouquet garni, they use the same vegetables and bouquet garni once again to prepare a new stock. So that is a remoulage stock. And bouillon is again a strained stock, but it could not be strained also. When you are serving a stock along with certain vegetables and bouquet garni is also there, especially when you are preparing some kind of soups, then we use this term bouillon. So bouillon comes under the category of thin soups in which these vegetables or meat pieces are floating, right? It is not strained. So types of stock, again we discuss all these things which I just told you. Bouillon is simply a broth made by simmering marpua and aromatic herbs with either beef, veal or poultry bones. Veal is a young one of a calf. Okay. Fume is a concentrated stock made with fish, and mushroom is used as a flavoring in this stock. Consomme is a clear, thin and past soup. Remember this definition of consomme always. It is a thin, clear and past soup made from richly flavored stock that has been clarified using a egg white. So egg white acts as a clarifying agent while we are preparing a consomme, right? Then coat bouillon, glaze, which is a reduced stock, remoulage, which is a stock which is prepared from the bones that already has been used once. So you discard the marpua and herbs after draining, and you add fresh marpua, and you can reuse the bones to prepare a remoulage stock. The bones for the stock are prepared usually by cleaning the bones. They are usually blanched or browned in case you want to prepare a brown stock, or they are sweated in a pan to release their nutrition and flavor. Okay, one by one we see how we process these bones. Blanching is to get rid of some of the impurities that can cause cloudiness. Rinse the bones in cold water to wash away the blood. Impurities dissolve easily in cold water, right? Hot water retards their extraction. So bring water to boil. As the water heat, impurities solidify and rise to the surface. Drain the bones and now ready for the stock pot. So that is how you clean the bones or you blanch the bones. Then for browning, you put the bones in an oven at around 375 degree Fahrenheit for 1 hour to brown. Then sweating the bones. Bones are sweated, and these proteins present in fish bones and shellfish can take on an acceptable flavor if allowed to cook for long. So do remember that you cook these bones for a desired amount of time only. Sweating is a procedure that starts flavor release quickly. The stock can be cooked in less than 45 minutes with full extraction of body and flavor. Okay, so how you sweat it? Heat a small amount of oil or clarified butter in a rondhu, in a pot. Clarified butter is basically desi ghee in Hindi. Add the bones or shells and marpua. You especially use shells while you are making shellfish soups like bisques. Okay, cook over moderate heat, stirring constantly until the flesh on the bones turns opaque or the shells have a bright color and the moisture is released from the marpua. That is how you sweat the bones. What are the four qualities of a good stock? Okay, a good stock can be evaluated based on its flavor, color, aroma and clarity. It is very important to have a clear stock, not a cloudy stock. Okay, you should have a clear stock. And remember, never use salt while preparing a stock and never cover the stock pot with a lid while you are preparing it. Okay, always use fresh ingredients. Cooling and storing the stock. Once the stock is prepared, you strain it and then put it in an ice bath or a water bath to cool it, and then store it in clean containers in a refrigerator for at least 3 to 4 days. You can keep it in the refrigerator and use as per your requirement for preparation of soups, sauces or gravies. You need to stir the stock occasionally because the sediments get settled down at the bottom. So I hope this was useful and you liked this short presentation on stocks, and I hope this made your concept very clear regarding the stocks. Now you understand what is a stock, how it is prepared, how it is used, what care should be taken while preparing a stock. So when now you will read about sauces, and in sauces you will read how you are using the stock as a liquid medium to prepare different sauces like velouté sauce, like brown sauce. In velouté sauce you use a white stock, in brown sauce you use a brown stock, so you will understand it better. I hope you liked this video and do remember to subscribe to the channel and share with your friends. Thank you.